not only are we not putting any pressure on this guy, and he's just throwing it where he wants to, he's not having to throw different dimes. He's not having to throw in the tight windows, any of that. We just giving him the plays. No pressure on him. Ugh. And then self-inflicted wounds. Like, not only do they get that catch and a first down, you get another 15 yards. They wasn't killing themselves with penalties like we was. I guess that's Tua's fault as well, though. We shouldn't have to depend on one person to dominate these trenches the whole game. This guy needs some help down there. One player dominating them trenches on a consistent basis every game. Boy needs some help in there, man. Third and 12, and they could have scored right here.
Easy throw.
They almost scored again.
Lucky he can't throw under pressure like Tua can.
If that boy would have thrown that ball and actually hit, he missed a lot of easy balls. Like I said, he a good quarterback, but he didn't have to play a killer quarterback game. We gave him half the game. He didn't have to do much.
Look at Trevor Mechanics when he under pressure, just like Kyle Murray. Tua one of the only players that step up into a blitz, throw the ball into his face like he don't even see him coming. He just showed that this game, he showed it plenty of times versus Oklahoma. And that wasn't the same blitz. We sent a linebacker. They sent a blindside cornerback that we never seen. So quit acting like that's the same blitz and Trevor just so happened to see it and we didn't.
First half stats, they go to obvious. One thing about that, when we do make mistakes, we can't stop them. Our defense ain't showed up the whole game except for the first drive. You take away that 3rd and 14 where we just let them run straight down the field behind our defense like the defense wasn't even on the field, and this guy got about 130 yards passing. The problem is we're not getting any balls like that. Their defense isn't just giving us plays. Matter of fact, they're forcing plays. Their defense actually is doing schemes designed to get Tua in this situation.
Clemson brought out new packages just for Tua Tagovailoa.
It's not just Tua out here making dumb decisions. He's getting baited into that by a great scheme defense.
Trevor staring down one receiver with no pressure.
It's not like Tua out here just making bonehead plays. He's getting baited in by great defense right now.
One play they knew, one play they tricked us. Otherwise, Tua been money.
Clemson's coaching staff is playing chess, not checkers. Two mistakes cost us, and we can't stop them on defense, so it's costing us. Clemson is doing what it takes to produce that. If we had the defense we had the last 2 years, it wouldn't be a problem. But right now, every turnover matter because they turning the turnovers into points. It's been plenty of quarterbacks that thrown two interceptions. Okay, let's get a 3-and-out and get the punt back. Or let's play some good D and get the ball back. We can't stop them. That's the problem. They forced those turnovers. Not only did they force the turnovers, they turned it into points. The running game doing good, but we can't rely on the run game because Clemson scoring every time they get the ball in the run game just eating up clock. Way to get that ball out of there, Tua.
Tua finishes with a higher passing completion under double the pressure.
Tua still throwing nice balls. But, of course, we shooting ourselves in the foot. We got our illegal receiver downfield with Jonah Williams right here. The tight penalties we got. Oh, we ain't even got to the penalties. Go back and look at the penalties. It's crazy. We just was not here today. First and 15. Play action. Got that run game working. Setting up that play action. Good move, Irv. Third and 6. Well thrown ball, on the money, and look at this. We got to kick a field goal because this ain't called. Oh my goodness. What is this? He turning his head and everything. He done turned my guy head and everything.
Perfect ball. Can't do nothing but NFL.
Come on, man. That ain't pass interference. That way before. And then he get up talking all that noise, making all that noise like he done did something. You just got away with a pass interference.
Yeah, I forget these plays.
Look at that. Oh my goodness. He riding me. What is this, ref? Is that legal? Maddie? What is that?
Even a Clemson fan see that.
I guess that Tua fault too.
He can't touch him before the ball get there.
Would have hit him right in his number. Look where else finna hit him at. In his number.
Perfect.
This boy all over his back just taking a ride.
Very next play.
4th and 6. Fake field goal. This describes our whole night. Look at 44 right here. 44 double team by 70 and Owens. Owens and Leatherwood. Look at 79. You want some more playing time, big boy? You definitely ain't gonna get it like this. Even Fletcher can get in on it. That's three people around. Look at the effort of this one guy. Look at the effort of this one guy. Them boys came down here on a mission, man. Look at you. You want some more PT? You definitely ain't finna get it like that, boy.
I'd rather keep Tua on the field any day.
Blows you up. That's the ACC.
He just threw a great ball on the play before, no call.
He wouldn't have got too much further. I just wanted you to see the effort we gave up front.
Dumbest play call since Georgia's infamous 4th-and-11.
Trying to put this game on one person. The whole team down here played like nothing. Trevor Lawrence is a good quarterback, but he ain't did nothing to outplay Tua today outside of Tua being forced to make 2 errant throws. Look at this, throwing out the back foot, but it's easy.
Embarrassing.
Because your receiver's out here making plays for you. That's 2 plays over 60 yards that you ain't had to do nothing on. The first one, 3rd-and-14, was one of the most embarrassing plays in Alabama history. Even though he didn't even score on the play. Just let a guy run straight down the field. And then this right here.
ID making you look good.
To a guy from Alabama that should be at Alabama.
Tua didn't have the luxury of throwing into busted coverages like Trevor. That don't make Trevor better than Tua, though.
This don't even make no sense. The running game working, but we can't run the ball because they scoring too fast. The running game ain't going to do nothing but eat up the clock. Unless we getting home run runs every run, then it ain't no way we can run the ball.
When we blitz, they go right at Savion.
Look at this. Physical. Oh, my goodness. Gracious.
His old double dead leg with a slap to the face.
I can't tell who in the SEC and who in the ACC in this game, man. This don't make no sense.
Had to blitz the whole team just to get some pressure, knowing it's going to leave Savion on the island.
This guy ain't even really doing that right now. And he can play. He just ain't forced to have to do much right now. He ain't doing much right now. His system just winning. He ain't having to throw in no tight windows. He ain't having to shred no needles. It's just easy right now. That's because of them.